If you have any desire to run an online legitimate e-commerce business, you need to watch this video. There's been a lot of issues popping up in the Facebook group regarding deactivated ad accounts, PayPal holding money, Shopify holding payouts, and it all comes down to registering your business. Shout out to Gazzaro. He left a comment mentioning how I haven't made a dedicated video regarding this topic, and I've mentioned it here and there, but it kind of shocked me to think I haven't actually talked to you guys about one of the most important aspects of starting an e-commerce business, and that is making it legitimate. So here I have my sole proprietor papers, my LLC papers are fully paperless, so they're online. I'll show you guys what it looks like. But I'm also gonna take you through which one is best for you regarding an LLC, sole proprietorship, and also how to get started depending on where you live. And this is really important. This is gonna prevent a lot of issues from occurring and gonna keep you on the good side of the legal aspect of running an e-commerce business. So without further ado, I'm gonna start breaking down how you can get started. This is one of my stores that I'm currently scaling, and it actually got hit with that warning from Shopify saying, hey, you need to submit your business papers, prove you're legitimate, or your payouts are gonna be held. So I submitted my papers, my LLC registration papers, and within 24 hours, everything was good to go. So you need to have this stuff ready to go at any amount of scale, and it's better just to do it from the get-go. So whenever you launch something new, you're prepared. Without further ado, let's get into the discussion of legitimizing your business. The two business types that we're going to be focusing on today is the green column, sole proprietorship, and the blue column, limited liability company, the LLC. And I'm going to talk about the pros and cons of each one, and then you can decide which one's right for you. And I'm going to do this very briefly because there is a ton of really good information out there that'll help you decide what's best for you. So I don't want to waste your time covering that, but I want to give you what's the pros and cons are related to Shopify. Sole proprietorship, there's no cost associated with registering. Limited liability, there is, and that depends on state, wherever you live. So for me, it was $700 to file, and then I pay a few hundred dollars every single year to keep my agent on board, and you need to have a registered agent every single month in the state of Illinois. So costs do add up with an LLC in Illinois. I know other states, it's like $30 to register a LLC. So really, this comes down to what state you live in. The next important row is personal liabilities. Let's say your business goes into debt, something happens, you get sued. As a sole proprietor, they can come after your personal assets. So if your business gets sued or goes into debt, they could take your house, they could take your cars, they can take what you own. If you have an LLC, however, they can only take what the business owns. The members are not held liable. So this is a huge aspect, especially in the world of e-commerce. If you get sued for some reason, you don't want to be liable. And that fee, to me, the fee of $700 to register in the state of Illinois, once again, it's a lot cheaper other places, and paying for the registered agent, it's worth it. You hear of these horror stories, you do not want to be held liable. So in my opinion, that's a huge benefit of the LLC. The next row that does affect us e-commerce entrepreneurs is taxation. So with the sole proprietorship, the sole proprietor is going to pay the taxes. The LLC though, if you have separate members, it is passed through to the members. So whatever the specific members make, they pay the taxes on that. It's not paid at the single entity level. But if you are a single member LLC, such as myself, then you pay taxes in the same way as a sole proprietor would. Once again, I'm not a tax expert by any means, so talk to your certified accountant or whoever does your taxes about this, but there's really no pros and cons like there is with tax in an S corp. But those are the three main rows that are important to us, and they should give you an idea. Ultimately, it comes down to the formation costs and the personal liability that really make the difference for us e-commerce entrepreneurs. So taken to the stage that you're at, what risk there is with this personal liability, do you have the money for the formation costs? And decide what is best for you. Because remember, even if the LLC isn't right for you, then you 100% should still register as a sole proprietorship. So now I'm going to talk about how to effectively set both of these up. So this is the page that I actually use to set up my sole proprietorship. And this is through the irs.gov. What you do is you come to this page, and this is if you're in the United States. I cannot help you if you're in a different country because I don't have experience with that. But I would assume it's relatively similar. And basically,
you determine your eligibility, and you need to have a valid taxpayer identification number, either your social security, an individual taxpayer identification number, or an employer identification number. So just hit apply online, follow the application, and do the sole proprietor. Go through this. It's going to authenticate you. You're going to give the address, and that is it, you guys. Then you're going to get a employer identification number, which is what I have here. So once you have this, when Shopify contacts you, what you can do is you have the documents to prove that you are a legitimate business. You are allowed, you are legally allowed to do business in your relative state. Mine says certificate of registration, sales, and use taxes and fees. So basically, this is saying that I'm legally allowed to make sales and pay taxes as a sole proprietor in my state, in my county. So that's incredibly simple to do. This is 100% the first step you should take if you're not sure if you're ready to go forward with an LLC. And the thing is if you don't have this and you're doing business, it's technically not legal for you to be doing. So when Shopify approaches you, you can provide them these payments and you'll be in the clear. This is also good for Facebook ads. You can provide your EIN and some more identification regarding your business. And I've seen it cut down on incorrectly disabled ad accounts. So now I want to hop into the LLC, which is what I personally recommend. I've personally used Rocket Lawyer in the past to set up an LLC. It was really expensive, overpriced. I found the service to be overhyped and really not necessary. There's a lot of upsells that they make seem necessary, but really when it comes down to it, you just need to file your LLC correctly and have a registered agent on board. And that's for the state of Illinois. Some places, I don't know if you need a registered agent all the time. This is the service I use. This is Northwest Registered Agent. I did a ton of research. This is by far the optimal cost, the most efficient cost, I should say. It's not the cheapest, but it's also a very good price for what they do for you and what you get. If you click on their services page and you come down to starting a business and click on we'll form your new company, it'll take you to form a new LLC or corporation. Once again, we're going to do the LLCs. You can select your state. So for me, it was Illinois, and it's going to show you how to start an LLC in Illinois. And it can kind of be intimidating, I'm not going to lie. You can submit this yourself. They do have the free download, the articles of organization, but you want to make sure this is filed correctly. So I would either do it yourself online, or if you have the money to do it, the 10-day Illinois LLC, this is what I did. This is going to take you a little longer than 10 days. And if you're already in the situation of a payout hold, this is absolutely worth it. So it includes your registered agent service, operating agreement, and there's more that they include. So it shows you what you're going to need. You're going to need your company name, your street address. And once again, this is regarding Illinois, the effective date of your business, your registered agent. So this is what they provide. And if you don't have a registered agent, you're going to need to hire one if you do it yourself. So once again, 10-day Illinois LLC, or the 10-day LLC comes with it. But yeah, go through this. It'll explain everything you need to know. And then basically, if you do the 10-day and pay that money, it is super intuitive and easy to do. And I'll show you what you end up getting at the end. So this is my LLC, Multiply Media LLC. And they have the filing at the federal level, at the state level, and then they provide the document. So if you come over to your registrations tab, you'll see your business registration. And you can see your registered agent, who it is, where they're located. You can call them if you need to. But let's check out the actual document here. I want to show you guys a document. So let me go to my following document. And so congratulations, Multiply Media is now formed and you now are permitted to do business. State of formation, filing date, and this is going to give you everything you need. And this is basically just saying that everything went good. Here's your document that proves like this was a successful registration. But the important one is the federal filing. So if we view this, this is from the actual IRS. So it shows your LLC, the location of the LLC. It's going to give you an EIN. Your EIN, your employer identification number, is what you're going to utilize to prove the existence of this registered business. If you have any plans to get a business bank account set up, business credit card, you're going to want to do the LLC and get this employer identification number. They asked for all of this information and more. And if I would have just had a sole proprietorship, I would have not been able to set up a legitimate business bank account and gotten the credit card opened. So it is important to do the LLC if you plan on running an e-commerce business at scale. Doing this for a long time, in my opinion, the pros of the LLC are much greater than the pros of the sole proprietorship. The sole proprietorship is good if your goal is to do $100 a day, maybe, or something like that. Just really low scale. But once again, you are held liable for every aspect of your business. And the LLC is the way to go if you're actually serious about doing this. I do apologize for taking so long to make this video. Once again, I was shocked that I hadn't covered this yet, because this is a very important aspect of doing online business or business of any sort. So I hope this video helped you guys out and helped you figure out what business registration you should move forward with first. Sole proprietorship is really easy and quick. So if you're thinking about the LLC, just get that proprietorship set up and ready to go, and then start filing the LLC. But if you are legitimately interested in doing this full time, full scale, get the LLC as soon as you can. If this helped you out, make sure to drop a like on the video, and I will see you in the next one. Dylan out.